Last week on WCW Saturday Night, WCW janitor Jim Duggan found a surprise in the garbage.
It's the WCW television title.
Wow. Scott Hall threw it away.
Well, folks, I don't think those primadonna millionaires realized when they threw this into the trash. In 20 years, history of professional wrestling, this represents the best that there is. 20 years, that's longer than all these other fancy damn wrestling shows combined. So I'm going to tell you what Hacksaw Jim Duggan's going to do. I'm going to take this belt home. I'm going to polish it. I'm going to clean it. I'm going to slam sandblast it if I have to.
Turn it sideways?
Because maybe I understand more than anybody else what this belt means. Because they tried to throw Hacksaw Duggan in the garbage before. Oh!
They tried it, didn't get him to fit in a bag.
So I come face to face with my fears, and I know what's important in life. So if somebody wants to challenge Hacksaw Jim Duggan for this belt, well, like the game show host says, come on down!
If I have to beat a dirty, foul, insignificant, downtrodden tart like you to get it, I bloody well will. And I'm so confident of my skills that if I can't beat you here on this show next week, I will retire from WCW.
Whoa!
You will never see Lord Steven Regal again.
And that's exactly what we have
right
now.
Wait a minute, you're disturbing my wish.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
I officially wish that what Steven Regal just said comes true.
You may get
your wish. Him again.
This may be it. Take a good look at that mug. This might be the last time we see it here at W. Look at the peak. Look at the peak on that bicep.
The peak, it's a wrinkle in a stupid shirt.
The career of Steven Regal is at stake. Former World Television Champion, former World Tag Team Champion. He may be hanging up the tights after this contest, or he may be Television Champion again.
But they're a very pompous guy, very confident, but also very capable. I mean, you cannot underestimate Steve Ring. This guy is very good on the mat. I mean, sneaky, he's got the European uppercuts, just rock you. Thing is, the European uppercuts won't be that effective against Hacksaw. He's just too thick, like trying to beat up a gorilla. You know, I mean, forget it, you'll just hurt your hand. But you can't out-wrestle Duggan. So this is going to be a question of how is Regal's mind? You know, what kind of state of mind is he in? Is he in the mind of being a big one from Wigan? Or is he going to try to out-slug an endomorphic man in Hacksaw Jim Duggan?
A who? An endomorphic man?
Look at him.
Hacksaw Duggan, the World Television Champion.
Oh. I mean, and they tell us the link is still missing?
Nope, there he is. Hang on, he's got a loaded 2x4 in there, and Steven Regal and Hacksaw Duggan. TV title versus career. Duggan doesn't seem to care.
He doesn't even take off that sweaty janitor suit.
Ugh, I don't like getting near that. You can smell it all the way over here.
Well, I know why.
Like
he leaves it on because he's finally realized that if someone punches him, it absorbs a lot of the shock and the slab, and it doesn't hurt as much. So now he's going to stay covered up.
You know, Steven Regal is in the best shape of his career. Steven Regal, only 28 years old, has been wrestling for 15 years.
Yeah, he's been around a long time. I'm telling you, very good. His only weakness is his own self-centered overconfidence, just underestimating everybody. And, I mean, blood to his royal blood, I mean, well, Hacksaw is a peasant to a lot of people, but especially Regal.
Misses the back elbow, Regal. Whoa!
And he got him!
Duggan caught him! A second clothesline!
Regal! Yeah, Regal got caught in Hacksaw's game plan, but he was smart enough to realize that he left the scene of the crime.
We've still got the World Tag Team Champion still to come.
The Marmalukes!
The Mamalukes still to come, but right now, Steven Regal may be facing his own destiny.
But Hacksaw's coming right at him! And that's his big weapons. He's got hands like bowling balls, brother.
Will he become television champion or will he become unemployed? That's what Steven Regal is facing. Hacksaw Duggan.
Regal doesn't care about the money. He's got plenty of money and jewelry and all that. But tell you, just the attitude alone of putting up your career is a pompous thing to do at 28.
Oh, forearm blocked by Duggan. Duggan, the big right meat hook. And a left, Regal, and a right.
Yeah, and Regal's just standing straight up. He's trying to outpower him, and that's a mistake.
Doom!
Regal should know better.
Regal sidestepped it. Duggan charged into that top turnbuckle.
Yeah, he could be in trouble now. Now he's in Regal territory. Regal knows how to hurt you here. He knows how to make you suffer.
Regal so very powerful.
He knows how to use the leverage. I mean, you don't have to be a pumped up muscle head to hurt somebody. It's just a matter of leverage. It only takes 15 pounds of pressure to break a knee if you got the right angle. So if you can push up 20 pounds, you can break a knee easy.
Steven Regal. Oh, a handful of hair of Hacksaw Duggan. I can't believe Regal would deign touch that hair of Duggan. Gonna have to have his hand fumigated. Now you see Regal putting a forearm right into the face of Duggan. The ulna, the radius bones in the lower half of the arm, just like 2x4s against your face.
Oh, yeah, and Regal rubs into the pressure points underneath the nose, in the eyeball sockets, bottom of the chin, yanking it back in. That's the only reason Regal's probably tying up with a Hacksaw, because he's wearing that suit and he doesn't have to touch peasant sweat.
Duggan fired back with a series of right hands, but Regal with a thumb to the eye. Regal fighting for his career. Not a textbook cover, and also grabbing a handful of ropes for extra leverage.
Yeah, now that was a very overconfident, pompous cover. See, but again, Regal goes right back into a little hole here, which makes Hacksaw suffer. Hacksaw's neck, very big, doesn't take much movement to hurt it. Yanking up on the nose.
Yee.
Every little trick in the book.
Regal has no pride. I can't believe he's touching Duggan's nose, for Pete's sake.
He has no conscience.
Last week, Hacksaw Duggan pulled the World Television Championship right out of the garbage where Scott Hall had put it 2 months ago. Named himself TV champ. Defended it last week successfully against Robert Gibson. He answered the challenge of Steven Regal. Regal offered his career for a shot at the title. Now Regal, boot to the chin.
No, he missed him.
Senton off the ropes, did not connect. Duggan, left and right. Now just right on Regal.
Dave's right back in Duggan's game plan. I tell you, 3 or 4 shots with that right hand, and your head is numb.
The left arm of Hacksaw Duggan may be numb after the attack. Concentrated attack by Steven Regal. Regal under the rope. Duggan catches it. What power from Hacksaw Duggan, the TV champion. He has Regal set.
He's got it in his eyeball. What's Sierra doing?
Right, Fidel Sierra has issued an open challenge to the winner of this contest.
Wait,
for next week.
Duggan's got him covered.
That's it, the old glory. It's over.
He got him.
Steven Regal is done.
Does this mean he has to go away now?
He must go now. Hacksaw Duggan, still the TV champion.
Hallelujah.
Steven Regal is going to hit the bricks to the unemployment line. Hacksaw Jim Duggan just sent Regal to the shower.
I don't think he'll see him in the unemployment line, but boy, you're sure going to see a very irate Regal if you see him, because this guy made a big mistake and just let Hacksaw pound him senseless. And this is what Sierra's going to get next week, too, if he doesn't learn to duck.
You know that Hacksaw Duggan is not going to back away from that challenge, especially from the Cuban, Fidel Sierra. And next week it will be Hacksaw Duggan and Fidel Sierra for the World Television Championship on Saturday night. And coming up next, how did Uncensored come to fruition? We will see Jeff Jarrett and Sid Vicious next.